Try to find a formula to go to figure what?
X.
Figure X. Figure X. To get to figure 3, we add on 2 2's. To get to figure 4, we add on 3 2's. To get to figure 78, we add on 77 2's. To get to figure X, we add on how many 2's? Sis?
I was
wondering
if you could say this because I need a little more.
To get to figure X, we need to add on how many 2's? Yep, to get to figure X, how many do we need? How many times are we going to add on 2?
As many as
not one time, time, not 2 times, not 3 times, not 77 times, but how many times?
X minus 1.
X minus 1 times.
Well.
Notice every time I pointed to a figure, go add on 3 2's. To get to figure 3, we'd add on 2. 1, 2. We'd add on 2 2's. To get to figure 78, we add on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 77 times we add on a 2 to get to 78. So to get to X, that number will not be the same as X. Then we add on like, the number of 2. That number will be 1 less than X, X minus 1. So there we go, there's a formula right there. Y equals start with the one circle. Trying to circle things. Start with this one circle. Add on from there 2 times however many steps it takes to get to that figure. Well, it always takes 1 less than the figure number if we start at figure 1. We could back up to figure 0. Well, if we follow this pattern of going up 2 every time, then how many circles would be in figure 0? Negative 1. It would have to be negative 1 so that I would add on 1, 2 circles and have positive 1 circle. Negative 1 plus 2 gets us to positive 1. So we could start that way. We could start with a negative 1 circles and add on 2 times. Well, if I start at figure 0, how many times do I have to step up to get to figure 3?
3 times.
Start from 0, we go 1, 2, 3 to get to figure 3. So it's different than starting from figure 1. How many times would I step up to get to figure 78, not James?
77.
If I started at 0 and step up 2, 3, 4, 78 times to get to 78. How many times to get to figure X?
X
steps to get to figure X, so in this case 2 times X because we're starting at figure 0. Here's number 4 on the worksheet. Okay, so we're starting with quite a few squares, blocks, or whatever you call them. And we're losing blocks from there. How many are we losing each time?
Six.
So we're subtracting 6. We're subtracting 6. If I kept going and subtract 6. The next figure. Like, how many would be in figure 4? Negative 4 in, so that doesn't make a lot of sense with blocks. But if these weren't blocks, but dollars, negative dollars, or if it was a distance, we could have a negative distance. There are negative numbers that make plenty of sense. So if we kept going, we would go into the negatives. Okay. If we were to back up, how many would be in this figure right here, figure 0?
20.
Right. 20 minus 6 gives us 14 that are in this figure. We back up 6 from there, we get the 8 that are in this figure. Back up 6 from there, we get the 2 that are in this figure. So on. So if we were to start at figure 1, we would have 14 blocks to start with. And from there, what would we do? Would we gain or lose blocks? We would lose blocks, we would subtract blocks from 14. How many blocks?
Six.
But only if I want to go to the next figure, right? I'd subtract, but if I want to go down to figure 3.
12.
I would subtract 12, right? That's 2 times negative 6. Mm-hmm. If I wanted to go to figure 27, what would I subtract then? Or how would I figure it out? 6 times what? You get to 27.
6 times 4.
Starting at figure 1.
5.
Yeah, we would have to subtract 6 once, twice, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26 times before we got to 27, figure 27. Right? We subtract 6 26 times. We get to figure X. We wouldn't subtract 6 26 times. We wouldn't subtract x, subtract 6 x times. We'd subtract 6 how many times?
X minus 1.
There's a good old formula right there. But what if I'm a different kind of person? I start from figure 0. Well, then I don't start with 14 blocks. I start with 20 blocks. And I subtract.
Six.
Still 6.
Times x.
Times x instead of x minus 1 because to start at figure 0 and get to figure 3, I would have to go, right, minus 6, minus 6, minus 6, that's 3 times. Figure 3, subtract 6 3 times. Figure 2, subtract 6 twice. Right? To get to figure X, we go X steps to get there because we started at figure 0. Wait, I have one more. Example with pencils. A real life example I've experienced many times whenever I put pencils out. Okay, so this jar will start off with, let's say, starts off with 17 pencils. One day later, let's say there's 15. 2 days from the beginning, there are 13 pencils. I'm going to write a formula for the number of pencils after X days.
Yeah. Okay, so we're starting at figure 0, we start at 17, right?
Well, are we starting at 0?
Yeah.
Can you convince everybody why we'd be starting at 0 instead of 1?
Because when it starts with, you have 17 pencils, and then one day is figure 1.
So after one day, like the number we're talking about here is 1. One day later, at day 1, there are 15. Which means if we back up, which day would this have to be that there are 17? The very start, which is, means how many days, 0 days have gone by, right? So we start at 0, so we start with 17. Okay. Start with 17. And what happens after that? We lose how many?
2.
We lose 2. Okay, so 17 minus 2, that would tell me how many I have on day 1, or after one full day has passed. If I subtract another 2, that's after 2 days, another 2, that's after 3 days, another 2, that's after 4 days. Right. So in this case, like Hunter said, we're starting at day 0. So how many days go by before we get to day 2?
1 day.
When we started back here,
oh, 2 days.
How many days go by until we get to day 2? 2 days. Because we didn't start at day 1. We started back here with 17 pencils at day 0. Here, let's look at it this way. Here's day 1. How many pencils are there on day 1?
15.
Or after one, after a full day has gone by. Okay. After 2 days, how many pencils are there?
13.
After 3 days, how many will there be?
11.
So that means when we started with 17, that must have been on day
0.
Okay. So if I wanted to get to day three, well, that would just be start with 17 minus 2 minus 2 minus 2. That's 3 times. Minus 2 times 3. So the day number and the number of steps to get to day whatever, the number of 2's that we subtract, it's all the same. The number of days, the number of 2's we're going to subtract, the number of steps it takes to get to day number 3. Right? Starting here, in 3 days, it'll be day 3. So, to get to the number of pencils on day 3, 17 minus 2 times 3, that's 17 minus 6, that's 11. Yay! So, what about day X? Day X, we're going to start with 17 pencils. We're going to lose 2 every day. 2X, 2 times the number of days that go by. If 3 days go by, well, that's what we're calling day 3. If 7 days go by, that's what we're calling day 7. So X and how many days have gone by happen to be the same in this example. We could start at day 1 if we wanted to, but that's not where the example starts. So why not just start at 0? You just have to recognize that's what's happening. You're starting at essentially day 0. Pay attention to the way the question is worded, the way the situation is set up. Does it start at 0? Does it start at 1? Does it start at 3? I could say that I didn't pay attention on the first day how many had gone, how many were there, right? And it was only 3 days later before I realized that I'd gone from 17 pencils down to 11 pencils. And then I would say, day 3 there were 11, day 4 there were 9, day 5 there were 7. So we can notice that pattern 3 days later. You just have to pay attention to what the question is asking you, what information is being given to you. Where are we starting? Starting at 0, starting at 1, starting at 5? You have to pay attention to that. Any questions about this? Other parts of the homework?
Yes.
Okay, well, let's get out a piece of paper, put everything else away.
Ah, crap.
Adding on 3 to get the next figure and the next figure, and then we would continue to do so in perpetuity. So, to build a formula, we just have to think, what am I doing to get to that figure? Well, first I'm starting with how many blocks?
4.
4 in figure 1. In figure 1, there's 4 blocks. And from there, we're going to get more blocks or lose blocks?
More.
All right, so we're going to add something on. What are we going to add on?
3.
3. Or we're going to add on 6. We're going to add on 9. We're going to add on 12. We're going to add on some multiple of 3. And we've noticed this many times over. Maybe this will be the one time for you that you that it clicks and you get that. To get to figure 3, I would add on 2 3's. I would add on 3 twice. I would add on 6. That's 2 times 3. To get to figure 17, I would add on 3 times what?
X minus 1.
17 just for starters?
I'm having a break.
16, right?
Sorry,
and so now the formula takes that mental calculation you do real quickly before you write it down, right? If I'm going to figure 17, I'll put a 16 right there. 4 plus 3 times 16, because it's 16 steps to get to figure 17, starting at figure 1. And mentally, if you were to go into figure 23, you throw a 22 there.
Wait, so if you put X minus 1,
oh, we're not done yet.
Oh, I'm like,
So, then we extend that thinking out to figure whatever. And when you get figure whatever number, you always subtract 1 from it, and that's what you put right there. Okay? And so you have to tell the person that's going to use your formula to do that. You have to tell them, okay, when you get figure X, take that figure number X, subtract 1 from it, Use that number, multiply that by 3. 4 plus 3 times 1 less than x, whatever x is, whatever figure number that is. And now we can use it for figure 2, figure 3, figure 17, figure 23, figure 1025. Okay, whichever we want. Jaden, you're having some problems.
Yeah, I am.
How dare you?
Alright, questions about that?
No.
No.
Okay. 3 fairly emphatic no's. Spanish no's.
Nothing so close.
So number 2.
Cramp.
Some kid named David.
David.
Keeping track of how many people are in the stands at any given time as the basketball gets ready to start. And if you read it, you gotta read it closely. Okay. He starts the stopwatch. So does it say how many people are there? When he starts, it doesn't say. It says at 1 minute, right? Only after there's one, after 1 minute has gone by. Okay. Stop. At 1 minute, now he keeps track of how many people are there. And you are that, are they 14? Okay. Some people, if you tell them that after 1 minute there's 14 people there, they make a faulty assumption. They assume that, what do you think they assume about how many people were there to start with?
0.
We didn't say 0. Or they might say 14 for minute 0. Put it away. I'm going to take it. Okay, so it's not minute zero that we're talking about, and we can't assume that there were 0 people when he started, because it just doesn't say. It doesn't say the gym was empty. He just showed up, started a stopwatch, and then after 1 minute, he said there's 14 people. And after 2 minutes, there are 22 people. And after 3 minutes, 30. So between 1 and 2 minutes, he starts to suspect that a steady number of people are walking into the gym. At 3 minutes, he confirms that how many people are showing up every minute. Eight people showed up here. 8 people showed up here. Could we back up and say now? He can kind of deduce how many people were there when he started the stopwatch. 6 people were there to start with. Okay. Assuming that this pattern continues back to 0 minutes. So he showed up pretty early, started a stopwatch, didn't record what time, or didn't record how many people were there, but at 1 minute he recorded it, and every minute since after that. And now David, instead of standing there and counting the people, he can just, well, he's got to kind of make an assumption that 8 people are going to keep walking in every minute. And then he can just kind of keep the stopwatch going until people stop coming into the gym. Or they're coming in so slowly that he's not going to worry about it anymore. And at times the people are coming in for 20 minutes, you can make an estimation about how many people are there. Right? So you call creating a model, using that model to make a prediction. So we're going to write the model, the formula that David might write to predict how many people are there after X minutes. It depends on how we look at this problem, whether we view it as starting at 1 minute with 14 people, starting at 0 minutes with 6 people. Let's vote on, should we start at 1 minute? Who thinks we should start at 1 minute with 14 people? Got one. Who thinks we should start at 0 minutes with 6 people? That's 4.5 votes. Okay, so we'll go with 0. So how many people are there at 0 minutes?
6.
6 people. So we're standing there, the gym starts it. We're assuming 6 people are sitting up in the stands. Not many people are there yet. Then people, right, the number of people increases. It goes up. We're adding on people. Okay. How many people?
8
people per minute, right? Every minute, 8 people show up. going out to minute X. You're starting at 0 minutes. So how many minutes are going to go by between minute zero and minute X?
X.
Is it X minutes or X minus 1 minute?
It's X.
X minutes because we're starting at minute zero. 1 minute passes, minute one. 2 minutes pass, minute two. 3 minutes pass, minute three. If we're starting at minute one, when 1 minute passes, we're actually at minute two. When you go to minute three, 2 minutes have passed. But since we started at minute zero, we can just add on 8 times however many minutes go by. Yeah.
If you would have started at 14, would you hit X minus 1?
You would.
Still be
X. So you start with 14.
That's what I heard.
Plus 8 times.
Yeah, X
minus 1. Because if I start at minute 1, well, when I go to minute 2, only 1 minute has passed. That's 1 8 that I need to add. Right? If I go to minute 3, that's 2 minutes that have passed. And I need to add 2 8 minutes, or 2 8 people, right? That makes sense. Add on 8 people twice. Three if I start at minute 1. So the thing I just need to make sure of is I start with the right amount of people, and I calculate this with the correct number of steps. I can start at minute 3 if I wanted. Well, I'm going to start with 30 people. I keep adding 8 people on. But if I want to go to from minute three to minute four, that's just one step, right? It's one step to get from minute three to minute four. If I'm starting from minute three, go to minute four.
Yeah.
And somehow when I plug in 4 minutes, it needs to turn into one step. So we're going to have to do X minus three if we started at minute three. See that? Start at minute 3 if we do X minus 3. Because now when I plug in 4, 4 minus 3 is 1. Yeah, there's one step to get from minute 3 to minute 4.
Okay, so we're going to minute
6. Now, all of these, this one, and this one, I use them all the same way. If I want to figure out how many people were there after 20 minutes, I plug in 20 there. I plug in 20 there, and plug in 20 there. Because starting from 0 minutes, I start with 6 people plus 8 times 20 people. 8 people per minute times 20 minutes. So if I start at minute 1, well, I start with 14 people, because I have people already showed up after minute 0. Plus 8 people per minute times, well, if I'm trying to go out to minute 20, that's only 19 more steps per minute 1. So 20 minus 1 is 19. Here, it's only 17 steps to get to minute 20, so 20 minus 3 gives you those 17 steps, times 8 people per minute, plus the 30 people we had at minute 3. And for both of these, if we were to distribute the 8 into the parentheses, combine like terms, we just wind up with 6 plus 8x. Okay. All right, so now we've been looking at these patterns for a little while, for several days, where the number of minutes, or the figure number, or the number of days, or number of hours, or whatever has gone by, is always going up by one. The next day, the next minute, the next figure. So let's see if we can throw a little wrench in the gears, but then recover and figure out the answer to this little bit of a challenge I'm asking. Here we go. All right, so let's, now instead of drawing figures and making you wait until I draw those figures and you having to draw those figures, let's just graduate a little bit to something a little more abstract,
okay,
where I tell you the figure number, or the number of minutes, or number of hours, or number of days that have gone by, just as X. And however, you can think of it as anything you want. If you want to think of it as the figure number, if you want to think of it as the number of minutes, or the number of days, it really doesn't matter, does it?
No.
It's all the same kind of pattern you're talking about. All right, so let's say at, I don't know, day one. Let's just call it day one, no reason in particular.
12.
Well, I already have numbers ready to go. 7, sorry. Okay, so at day one, there's 7.
Oranges.
Oranges, sure. Okay, you got a tree, 7 oranges on day one. Then, a few days later, on day 4, there are 16 oranges. So here's the question on day 8. How many oranges are there? Can you figure that out? Page 28.
What?
Now, if you said 25, then you kind of fell for the trick. Okay? Because you probably noticed that from 7 to 16 was an increase by 9, right? Hey, and this went from 1 to 4.
Oh!
Yeah. So let's go up another 4, and that should go up another 9. But did this go up from, did this go up 4 from here? How much did it go up?
3.
It went up 3, not 4. It went up
gosh,
three.
Dang it.
This went up by 4. Well, so how do I figure out how much it goes every day? Well, it went up by 9 oranges. And how many days went by?
3.
So how many is that per day?
3.
How many per day if it goes up 9 or 3 days? Every day, 3.
3.
So now we have the pattern of how many it should go up every day. 3 per day. Now we can use that pattern to go from 4 days to 8 days and figure out how many oranges, right? We should see an increase of, well, this goes up 4, right? 6, or sorry, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 4 days go by. So we should see, right, an increase by 3 oranges every day. 3, 6, 9, 12 oranges for 28 oranges. Okay, so here's your homework one. 1 and 5. On day 1, there's 8. Day 5, 24. Show how many on day 26. Question, that's all your homework is.
I don't have